my channel, and today's Wash and Go styling, I am going to be using the Define and Shine Custard from Cantu. I have done a product review on Cantu's products. I had done one on the coconut styling cream, and I had cocktailed it with the Define and Shine Custard. If you'd like to watch that video, just click on the link that's going to pop up somewhere on top of the video somewhere here. All right, but today's video is focusing on just the Define and Shine Custard. All right, so let's get into the video. So we are starting out with washed and dry hair. I had washed my hair yesterday, and I have applied leave-in conditioner as well and oil. The reason I decided to wash my hair a day before actually styling it is because I had watched an Instagram live video of a hair specialist, and what she had mentioned is if you find that your hair tends to dry up, leaving product residue in your hair, that you should try and possibly wash your hair a day before you style, let it dry, apply the leave-in conditioner, let it dry, and then the following day use the styling product. So my hair is prone to drying with residue, so I decided to try that. And another reason why I may experience that is because my hair is low porosity, so to absorb moisture it takes quite a bit of a while, and it dries, it takes a while for it to dry. But anyway, so I decided to try this out and see how it goes. So yeah, so that's why I have my hair is currently dried, and I already applied my leave-in conditioner and oils. I did use the Cantu leave-in conditioning repair cream. I'm just going to show you guys what it looks like, and that there it is. And I had just used, for my oil, I had used the coconut oil, so that's what I use for my oil. All right, so what I do have here with me today that I will be using, I have my water in the spray bottle. I did put a little bit of glycerin, and I think I mentioned that in my previous video that glycerin is a humectant. It helps with attracting moisture into your hair. So I do like to use that. And I do have the Define and Shine Custard, which is our main styling product today. There it is. And I have some hair clips. I have some hair clips here. And I do have my tail comb to help with sectioning my hair out. And I have my rubber bands, which I will use to put my hair into section. All right, so there it is. All right guys, so let's get into this. And I also wanted to mention that I will be using the shingling method for today's styling. All right, let's get into the video.
All right, so I'm going to start up with parting my hair into four sections. It makes it easier when you work in sections, so I do recommend that you do that as well. Alright, so I'm going to be going in line by line into each section, and then going to go ahead and spritz some water into my hair. So this is the glycerin and water mixture. And after I do that, I'm just going to be rubbing it in just to make sure that my hair gets wet evenly, Alright, so we're going ahead now and applying the Define and Shine Custard from Cantu. And now I am going to further start parting the strands I want to work with. So I'm just rubbing it in. This is shingling. So I'm shingling, and then I'm finger curling at the end just to help my strands actually get that good curl definition. So shingle and then finger curl at the end. Now you can choose to make your hair strands fatter as you shingle through. Mine is a little bit tiny on the tinier side. Now if your hair is quite dense, you may want to make the strands fatter as you're shingling through, so you're not spending a lot of hours just getting your hair done. Now the curls are coming along. I'm loving what I'm seeing. I'm liking the definition that I can see while I'm shingling. Now with shingling, when you use shingling, you're able to help your curls to look better defined. It is time consuming, but the end result is usually, well, for me, worth it. Now, if you compare shingling with the raking method, the raking method is faster, but in terms of how much control you can have over the definition of your curls, it's not as much as if you were shingling. As you can see, I'm going through strands, I'm separating strands, and I'm rubbing in the product and then finger curling at the end. This helps with a better defined curl. So we are all done with the hair. Now, so I'm going to just let my hair air dry and I'll come back and show you guys the end result.
All right, so this is how my hair currently looks like after the styling using the Define and Shine Custard. I'm going to give you guys a closer look so you can see exactly what the results look like and you can make your own conclusions. So I'm going to do that. So my thoughts on the product, first off, it helps to control my frizz, which is great. So it gives me frizz control. With any styling product, you would want that in a product. So it does check off frizz control. I love that. Now next is the curl definition I was able to achieve using the custard is great. I love it. It helps my curls, it helps define the curls more. So that, it does check off on that. So I love the curl definition. Now the other thing I wanted to mention, I had mentioned early on in the video that I had washed my hair a day before and added my leave-in conditioner and my oils and let my hair dry before actually styling my hair with the styling products. I was doing that to try out a method or an approach with styling my hair because my hair, I've noticed sometimes with certain products, when my hair dries off after I've styled it, it leaves behind residue. So product residue when it dries off. So I have some products clinging to my hair and it comes out white at some time. So I wanted to try, I was trying out this method because a hair specialist had mentioned, let's try it that way. You can try it that way and see if when the hair dries off after you've styled it, if you still experience that residue. And with the Cantu with the custard, I still did experience the residue being left behind. It dried off with some white stuff showing in my hair. So I actually had to wet my hair a little bit again and then use a towel and just scrunch just to kind of like soak in some of the products to see if it did make a difference a bit when I did that. So I don't have as much residue in my hair. But anyways, I said this to say that the method or what I was trying out didn't really work out. So I may just keep my styling the way I do it, wash it, style it the same day, let everything dry together, or I might continue to try this and see if I like it that way, like this approach of doing it one day, washing your hair one day, and then styling the next day. Well, we'll see, I'll decide, but I just wanted to let you guys know that. And also another thing I wanted to mention with the product, my hair feels, it feels crunchy, which is not crunchy, not too hard of a crunch. It's just the frizz control. It helps with the frizz control. So it does feel crunchy, but I'm not mad at it at all. I'm okay with the crunchy feel. Some people may not like that, but I'm okay with the crunchy feel. It's not that bad, so it's good. So that I wanted to mention. But overall, I do like a custard from Cantu, the Define and Shine custard from Cantu. It gives you the frisk control, which is what you want with wash and go styling. It helps with the curl definition. Anyway, I'm just listing off what I've been able to experience with the product. Now, from your hair, depending on your hair type and some other factors, it may differ in terms of what results you end up with. But based on my hair, I'm a 4C, type 4C, and low porosity. It's helped with my curl definition. It's helped control frizz. So I would say it is a great product for styling. If you want to use that for your wash and go styling, it is a good product. Try it out. I would recommend that. All right, so I would recommend it. All right, so those are my thoughts on the product. Let me know your thoughts, guys. If you've used the custard, what your experience was like. Did you experience some residue after it dried off? Or was it A-okay when you used it? Let me know your thoughts on it. Let me know your thoughts in the video. Let me know if you have any tips for your girl. Just leave a comment down. And thank you guys for watching. And please subscribe. Please like. Please share. And I will see you guys in the next video. Take care, guys.